This weekend, we're going to be giving thanks for the community in which we live because this is Greenlaw's mini festival weekend. And we're also going to be asking God's blessing on the village. Now, nowhere on this earth is perfect, but everywhere on this earth has the potential to be a place where people feel they belong and are safe, and where everyone can get the encouragement they need for us all to be all we can be. Today, as I say, we're going to be celebrating what it means to be community, and we're going to see if we can play our part in promoting that community. Now, there's no better way of bringing people together than through singing. Blokes do it at rugby and football matches, and everybody does it at festivals. So let's sing. In church, when we gather, we speak to God and we listen for God, and we call the conversation prayer. Some people close their eyes to help them to focus when they pray. Others keep their eyes open. However we do it is not really all that important. What matters is that we engage with God. So let's do that now. Creator God, we can't see you, but you can see us. You made each one of us, every person on the planet, as well as the planet itself. Thank you for this beautiful world. And thank you too for entrusting it to our care. Help us to look after it. Help us too to look after each other. We confess that sometimes we say things we shouldn't and we do things that we shouldn't too. When we hurt other people, when we're unkind, then please stop us in our tracks and help us to say sorry. Then help us to try to do and to be better. Creator God, you sent us your Son Jesus to show us how to live. Help us to follow his example, caring for all around us, especially the least loved and the least liked. We finish this conversation by saying together some words that Jesus taught his friends. We say, Father in heaven. Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial. And deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Whenever we gather in church, we hear a reading from the Bible. The Bible is a book that Christians turn to to learn about God's thoughts and ways. It's in two parts, the Old Testament and the New. In the Old, there are lots of ancient stories of long, long ago. In the New, we hear Jesus' stories, and we hear too about the birth of the church. We're going to hear a Jesus story today. A man called John tells the story. John was one of Jesus' first followers. Listen to what he says. John chapter 6 from verse 1. After this, Jesus went across Lake Galilee, or Lake Tiberias, as it's also called. A large crowd followed him because they had seen his miracles healing the sick. Jesus went up a hill and sat down with his disciples. The time for the Passover festival was near. Jesus looked around and saw that a large crowd was coming to him, so he asked Philip, "Where can we buy enough food to feed all these people?" Philip answered, "For everyone to have even a little, it would take more than 200 silver coins to buy enough bread." Another one of his disciples, Andrew, who was Simon Peter's brother, said, "There's a boy here who has 5 loaves of barley bread and 2 fish. But they will certainly not be enough for all these people." "Make the people sit down," Jesus told them. There was a lot of grass there. So all the people sat down. There were about 5,000 men. Jesus took the bread, gave thanks to God, and distributed it to the people who were sitting there. He did the same with the fish, and they all had as much as they wanted. When they were all full, he said to his disciples, "Gather the pieces left over. Let's not waste a bit." So they gathered them all and filled 12 baskets with the pieces left over from the 5 barley loaves which the people had eaten.
Jesus was worried about people. They'd come looking for him because they wanted him to help them. And now they were away out in the middle of nowhere with no shops to buy food in the days long before mobile phones and cars. How were people going to face the long walk home on empty stomachs? Jesus turned and asked his friends what they should do. And those friends hadn't a clue. "None of us has enough money to buy the amount of food that we would need to feed this lot," they said. "And even if we did have enough, there are no shops around here anyway." It was a friend of Jesus called Andrew who told Jesus that a young boy had just volunteered his packed lunch, his 5 bread rolls and his 2 wee fish. "But what's that among so many?" Andrew had asked Jesus. But Jesus took that wee boy's packed lunch and sat everybody down. He said a prayer, and then he proceeded to hand out the bread and the fish. And do you know what? Somehow, everybody had enough to eat. There was even some left over. A lot, actually. 12 baskets full left over. A fishy tale? Well, really, it is a tale of how even the tiniest of efforts in Jesus' hands can produce the most amazing things. But don't take my word for it. Here's a wee song that says just that.
When they went out, well, they went to hear the Lord, and as the day went on, the crowd just grew and grew. When they went out, there were 5,000 hungry men and lots of hungry women and their children too. So then Peter, well, he went up to the Lord and said, "These folks are hungry, but we have no food." But you know what? They were just about to see the mighty things that God can do. Then Jesus fed 5,000 men with women and kids. There were thousands more. Yes, he's the one who fed 5,000 men with 5 loaves, 2 fish, and that's all. So they went out just to see if anyone had thought to carry any food. All they found out was a single little boy, one single boy who had some loaves and fishes too. they brought him,
and they brought him,
yes, they brought him to the Lord, and probably wondered what the small amount could do. But they took out, he took out his little lunch and said, it isn't much, but I'll give it to you. Then Jesus fed 5,000 men with women and kids. There were thousands more. Yes, he's the one who fed 5,000 men with 5 loaves, 2 fish, and that's all. Everybody ate their fill. There were 12 baskets left over when they're through. Jesus fed them, all because one little boy gave us all, although he only had a few. When I go out, when I go out, well, I know I wanna be a man who follows what is true. I'm gonna give all,
gonna give all,
gonna give all to the Lord, and then I'll see the mighty things that God can do. I wanna see what God can do. Don't you? 'Cause Jesus fed 5,000 men with women and kids. There were thousands more. Yes, he's the one who fed 5,000 men with 5 loaves, 2 fish, and that's all.
So, how good are you at sharing? Some people are really good at it. They'll share their time, their energy, as well as what they have with others. Other people are not quite so good. Sometimes, though, we can think we don't have much to share. But what the little boy in our Jesus story learned is that when we do dare to share, even when we think what we have is not a lot, when we do dare to share, we open the door to all sorts of possibilities for everyone. I'm reminded of a very old story that is told in lots of different countries and cultures. The story is of a travelling man. But rather than me tell it, how about watching it? Throughout much of the world, there are tales of the legend that is the story of Stone Soup. A European version tells the tale like this. Once upon a time, in a land very near, there was a traveller who travelled his way to and through all sorts of towns and villages. Some say he was poor. Others say he was incredibly rich in wisdom and understanding. One day the man found himself in a part of the kingdom he didn't know at all well. He drew near to a village and thought to himself, I will ask for a drink of water and perhaps for some bread too. The traveller pushed on. The village, as he approached it, looked bare. The houses looked a little dishevelled. The man saw a woman and decided to ask her for water. When he got close to her, the woman drew her children tighter to her. The traveller smiled and lifted his hat. Good afternoon, he said to the woman. I'm travelling through your village and wondered if you might have a drink and some bread that you could spare. I haven't eaten since yesterday. The woman slowly shook her head. Sad to say, sir, that this is a poor village. We don't have much at all and can barely feed our children. I will fetch you some water from the well, though, and perhaps you should keep walking and ask for food at the next village. The man told the woman that he was grateful for her kindness. Then he took from his pocket a stone. Might I trouble you for a cooking pot as well as some water? The traveller asked. I have a pot, the woman said. We all have pots, but nothing much to put in them. I have a very special recipe, the traveller said. The recipe is for stone soup.
Stone soup, laughed the woman. If only stones could feed us.
Please, said the man, let me share it with you. And the man set a fire and sat down to watch the pot the woman brought boil.
Then he carefully placed the stone in the boiling water and sniffed the air. Stone soup takes a while to cook, he said. Perhaps as we wait, you could tell me about yourself and about your village. The woman told the traveller a sad tale of war and widowhood, and all the while the man stirred the soup. Do you know what would make all the difference to this soup? It would benefit greatly from just a little salt and pepper. I'm sure we have that in our cupboard, the woman said, and sent her children to fetch some. They came back with salt and pepper and brought a few of the neighbours too, who were curious about what was going on. The travelling man is making stone soup, the children told them. So the neighbours waited and watched. Tell me your story, the traveller asked the new arrivals. And one by one they talked of love and of loss and of life. Ooh, said the man, the soup is almost ready, but you know, the best stone soup I have ever had had a few carrots in there. I'm sure I've got a few carrots, said one of the neighbours, and quick as a flash, some carrots appeared, along with a few more villagers. The villagers talked while the man stirred the soup. Doesn't that smell so good? He asked the gathering crowd, and all the villagers agreed. I have a few potatoes I can add, volunteered an old man, and the children ran off to fetch them. The chatter grew louder as the villagers caught up with each other and shared stories and tears and laughter. This is such a beautiful day, the man said out loud, and everybody agreed. The air felt fresher than it had done for a long time. Then someone asked, is it nearly ready? The stone soup, I mean. And everybody laughed, including the traveller. It is very nearly ready, he said. And the smell reminds me of the very best stone soup I have ever eaten. That stone soup, though, that had some cabbage in it. The next thing the man knew, he was being handed a cabbage. The best of days deserves the best of ingredients, a young woman's voice said. And the traveller smiled his thanks and shredded the cabbage, adding it to the soup. The crowd grew merrier and the singing began, softly at first, and then it grew louder and louder, and people were enjoying their afternoon together. By the time the soup was ready, the whole village had come to life, and together they shared the stone soup the man had made. They all talked late into the night, and then realised there was no traveller, no pot on the fire. But there was a stone. And under the stone they found a note. It's not the stone that makes the soup. It's all of us together.
prayers of intercession on site this morning will be led by the young people, who will take from a basket of prayers, some of which will necessitate a further conversation, and some will just be asking God for something. Prayers for others, the world, and us. When we meet together on a Sunday, it's not all about us. We like to ask God to help all sorts of people. We ask God to look after those going through hard times and to do things like bring peace to the world. We ask God to be with those who are growing older in our community. Help us to look out for each other and to offer a hand where we can. How do we do that? Fetch a paper, cut the grass, put the bin out and back in again. We thank God for a beautiful world and ask God to help us care for it as the wonderful gift that it is. How do we do that? Taking litter home, switching off lights, not leaving things on standby. Have no screen time days. We pray for a more peaceful world and ask God to help us to work for peace wherever there is fighting and wherever people are frightened. We pray for a world that dares to share. Too many people need food banks and help with bills. May God help us to do all we can so that no one goes hungry in Scotland or in any part of the world. We ask God to protect those who feel bullied or used. Help us, Lord God, to notice when others are suffering. May we reach out a hand and not turn away. Living God, the world needs to be a place where we are welcome and all have what they need to live. Help us here in Greenlaw to be a welcoming community, caring for all in the village, from the oldest to the youngest. Help us to go out of our way to be friendly and encouraging. Make us generous in the time we have for each other, and let that friendliness locally spread throughout the whole wide world. We say Amen, which really means let it be. But it's good too to say thank you for all the good things we enjoy. So let's say a thank you for this mini festival weekend and for all who organised it. Let's say a thank you too to Carly and her court for being so gorgeous. Thank you too for parents and friends too, making things special. Above all, thank you for coming here and for making this time to look for God's blessing.